Hello, thank you for having me. I'm very privileged to be up here on this stage tonight. But I'm going to start with a social faux pas. I'm going to tell you about a dream I had one night. So I'm going to ask you to follow my instructions. Please close your eyes. Breathe in, breathe out. I'm dreaming. I'm seeing things from above, so I have a good overview. It is a gray autumn forest at dusk, and in the clearing below, I see a Viking Age longhouse. I know there are visitors being regaled inside the house. They're having a drunken feast in the great hall. Suddenly, a high-pitched and frantic scream is heard. Someone, a young woman, runs out of the building, dressed in a pale blue dress and furs, and in her hand she holds a long distaff. Behind her come several women and androgynous people who are trying to catch up to her. When they reach her, she plants her long distaff into the ground and she cries out to the gods, "I do not care, there must be vengeance." And the wind, it picks up and the thunder rolls, and the wind goes up into the air and comes crashing down as a storm gale atop the longhouse. Vengeance has come, and it has come for each and every one. You can open your eyes. This is what my dreams are often like. They're full of places, details, characters, and power dynamics. In the last several years, my LARPs have been based on dreams like these. It has been a great creative resource for me, and what I do realize, not everyone remembers their dreams. I know more of us could, and that's what I will talk about today. I've learned most of my techniques from methods which are used to reach the so-called state of lucid dreaming, which some of you might have heard of. This is a state where you are asleep and dreaming, but then you become aware that you are dreaming, and you can take control. Here, I'm just listing the methods that I use, but I also have some link available for those who wish to have them later on. My goals have also been to have vivid dreams, not lucid dreams, because I don't need to control my dreams to be inspired by them. The first foundation is always good sleep hygiene. There are many good resources about how to get good sleep hygiene online, so we won't get into that. But some medications might also have vivid dreams as a side effect, so you get those for free. If you already have vivid dreams, you can learn how to do a so-called reality test. One common test is, if you find yourself in a situation feels slightly off, try to push your fingers through your opposite hand, like this. If your finger pushes through, you are dreaming. I hope. Also, write a dream diary. A dream diary is a physical notebook or a note-taking app just on your phone. You jot down the details you remember as soon upon waking as possible. I myself prefer to use a physical notebook because it's also easier to make drawings of what I saw. But sometimes all I have are notes on my phone. It also happens that upon waking, I have this strong urge inside that I have to tell a specific person about my dream. So in that case, I mostly write it to them in a private message. Sometimes I do post on Facebook, but people aren't that interested in reading about other people's dreams. However, another way is using mood boards, such as Pinterest or other services like that, just to capture the mood of the dream. I have several such Pinterest boards for Wishesfesta Farm and for Vedergällningen, but also for some projects and ideas who have not become LARPs yet. I can show you them. Each time you document a dream, it will be easier to remember the next vivid dream you have. I also sometimes set the intention that tonight I will dream about this subject, and I partake in a lot of media about the subject, and I fall into sleep fantasizing about the subject. This is mostly something I use when I'm going to another person's LARP and I need more like ideas about my characters. But there's a name for this, and it's called mnemonic induction of lucid dreams, MILD. You can also attempt to use wake-initiated lucid dreaming, WILD. To do this, you lie down, you relax, into a state where you start to have something called hypnagogic hallucinations. Though, some find this wildly uncomfortable because the first stage of those hallucinations is being paralyzed. And then the hallucination set in. I try to then maybe take charge of the hallucination as we go deeper into sleep state and the dream kind of starts fleshing out. I ask the characters questions. And I ask them if we could maybe look around at some other parts of the dreamscape. This mostly makes them uncomfortable. So now I might have succeeded in having a very vivid dream. I have documented it in a diary or found images online. What can I actually use to write a LARP? Well, I usually don't lift a scene I dreamt, as I don't actually like designing with scripted scenes. But the dream I described a moment ago, the lamentation of the völvas after a hideous crime had been committed against them, it made it into the LARP Vedergällningen, which means the vengeance. And in my LARP Witches of Ästad Farm, the British diplomats arriving at a Swedish internment camp for witches during a Second World War was taken directly from a dream. So what do I usually take away from those dreams that are this inspiring? I lift general mood and the big dilemma, if one could be identified. I lift the general time period and costuming I saw in the dream, but it can be redefined if needed. If I saw characters or kind of knew of characters off stage, I enter those into a gallery of characters which I use, and then I extrapolate the rest of the characters played for the LARP. Like if I knew there was a nurse I was kind of avoiding, there should be a whole medical team. If I saw a Viking sob over his dead brother in arms, they could come from a Viking ship crew. I try to not get too caught up in finding a location that matches exactly what I saw in the dream. And I rather try to make do with what is available at the time, as it helps keeping ticket prices down. If you want to talk more about learning to dream or how to take vivid dreaming into your LARP creations, please come talk to me. I find it very rewarding and like I'm working with my unconscious instead of against it. But the weirdest moment of all is being on site for the LARP and seeing people I know playing at something I several months ago saw in a dream. And that's the moment when I try out some reality testing. And so far, my fingers have not passed through my hand.
Thank you so much.